phrasal verbs.
Phrasal verbs. They are very common in spoken and informal English. They indicate action and are constituted by two parts, a verb and an adverb or preposition. For example, stand up, sit down. In this particular phrasal verbs, the adverb or preposition comes right after the verb. Sometimes the adverb or preposition is located after the object. For example, put your toys away. We can also say, put away your toys. The order of the object and the adverb or preposition can usually be changed, unless we are using a pronoun for our object. For example, let's use the pronoun them in place of the toys. We say, put them away. We cannot say, put away them. If using a pronoun as the object of a phrasal verb, it must go between the verb and the preposition or adverb. The meaning of some phrasal verbs are more obvious. They are literal. Stand together with up means to stand up. But many phrasal verbs are not literal. They are figurative. The meaning of a phrasal verb can often be something completely different to the base verb. This means that phrasal verbs need to be memorized individually. Take this phrasal verb, make up. The verb make means to build, form, fabricate something. You could make a pizza. But the phrasal verb make up means something completely different. Make up refers to people reconciling, like in, I wanted to make up with my friend after our fight. Here's another phrasal verb, look up. It can be used literally, like in Astrid looked up in the starry sky. But the same phrasal verb can mean something different, like to search for information in a book or a database, like in he looked up the word in his dictionary. Or it can mean to admire someone, for example, your fans look up to you. When you come across a phrasal verb you don't know, try looking for clues in the sentence to help you work out what it might mean. You might be surprised how often you can work them out.